Today this could be the greatest day of our lives. Before it all ends, before we run out of time, stay close to me. Stay close to me. Watch the world come alive tonight.
Everything matters. Inside the new Nationwide Children's Hospital. Now, 10 TV's Jerry Revish and Kristen Hartman.
Hello, I'm Jerry Revish.
And I'm Kristen Hartman. Welcome to Everything Matters inside the new Nationwide Children's Hospital.
We are standing in front of the biggest pediatric expansion project in the country. And the goal here is not just to build a bigger hospital, but to build a future for pediatric care in Central Ohio.
Tonight, we take you inside a place where everything matters.
120 years ago, a group of women in Franklin County realized some children in our community weren't getting the care they needed because their parents couldn't afford it.
So they went out and did the first fundraising drive and put up a 9-room hospital, which doesn't exist anymore. But that founding mission of not ever denying a child because their parents couldn't pay for it still is what drives almost all of our decisions here.
Over the past 120 years, Nationwide Children's Hospital has grown to what it is today, a nationally prominent pediatric health care and research institute providing care and compassion to sick children and their families.
Tell us about the inspiration for this new expansion.
Well, part of the justification for it, Jerry, was just that we have grown at such a rate that we've just run out of room. And we needed more contemporary facilities in order to provide the care that the children in this community deserve. So the thought behind this is that we would need to put up a new hospital tower that would meet the needs of the patient-centered care that we wish to do, but also have the capability to provide what state-of-the-art medicine that we think these children need.
With a mission of making sure every detail matters, leaders at Nationwide Children's Hospital gathered the best minds from across the country and here at home to plan, envision, and build this new hospital. A family advisory committee helped give input on what is best for the patients and their families, and doctors and nurses, staff members all contributed to help create the new building.
Everyone's partnered in this. So the city was our partner, the mayor and the county commissioners. I mean, there are just so many people who really, you know, came together to create the best possible environment. So for me, it is an exciting moment,
yeah.
But it's a moment that's part of a much longer journey. And that journey began 10 years ago. With really looking at it, this institution and saying, you know, we have a wonderful community hospital, it became a fabulous regional hospital, but how do we really take it to that next level? How do we become a nationally recognized institution where parents feel, those parents who live here in Columbus know that their kids are getting the absolutely best care that's available anywhere in the world, right here at home, and that would attract families from outside the community to come to be treated here.
2 years of planning, 4 years of building. When Nationwide Children's Hospital opens its new doors to the public on June 20th, 2012, the campus expansion adds 2.1 million square feet of clinical, research, and support space to the existing facilities, opening with 460 beds, 293 of those in the new main hospital, and an additional 2,000 employees.
Our families deserve the most family-centered, interactive, responsive setting that we could create for them.
So that was the goal?
That was the goal. And this is just a piece of that goal. And, you know, hopefully we've been very thoughtful in the planning. We've done an entire facilities master plan that takes us through the next 25 years, as opposed to building buildings on top of themselves.
Inside the new main hospital, a giant tree fills the main atrium.
New patient rooms are double in size.
a new emergency department, Level 1 Pediatric Trauma Center.
Child Life Play Spaces on every floor. Rehabilitation and clinical therapy space with a full-scale car.
And a magic forest.
On the roof of the new building, a new heated surface helipad.
Outside, an additional 6 acres of green space, including family gardens and walking paths, and underground patient parking.
I think part of what we were saying is, you know, no child, no family wants to be here. I mean, you don't want to have to experience this, but if you do, how do we honor our families? How do we honor our kids and try to make it an environment that is, you know, as pleasing as we can make it for them?
So in the end picture, is this about peace of mind, knowing something like this is here?
Absolutely. It's about peace of mind. It's about, you know, realizing that we have a jewel in this community. It's always been supported by this community. This community steps up every time to be behind this hospital and giving back to the community, creating this jewel here. I think it's a wonderful thing.
The expansion of the new Nationwide Children's Hospital goes beyond the building of a new hospital and research center. This place is really an important part of the surrounding community.
And the people inside are working with community organizations to make the neighborhood around the hospital an even better place in which to live.
Everything matters to Laquita Long when it comes to her two little girls.
This lovely lady over here to the right is my 6-year-old. This is Aziza, and she's diagnosed with cerebral palsy, so she's a children's hospital patient from birth. And then this is my 4-year-old, Thea, and she's a children's hospital patient every now and then.
Ziza spent 360 days of her young life at Nationwide Children's Hospital.
I knew that with Ziza not walking and being in wheelchair, we could not really deal with any stairs for a living.
When looking at buying a new home, Laquita learned about healthy neighborhoods, healthy families. The Neighborhood Revitalization Initiative, launched in 2008 as a partnership among Nationwide Children's Hospital, the United Way of Central Ohio, Community Development for All People, and the City of Columbus.
The primary activity we've done with that is a renovation of housing stock. We've taken a number of homes that aren't in very good condition. We've arranged with a number of partners in Columbus to renovate those homes and then sold them to people to encourage people to move back into the South Side.
The initiative focuses on 38 square blocks with the intention of improving the neighborhood in two ways: by purchasing every vacant, blighted house and renovating it to be an owner-occupied home. The other, by providing grants to existing homeowners to fix up the exteriors of their homes.
The Healthy Neighborhoods, Healthy Families initiative by Children's Hospital is making a huge difference to the area around Children's Hospital. Over 100 homes are being renovated, and what was once a vacant and abandoned home, a new family with new hopes and dreams and opportunities will be invested in that house that's been renovated through this initiative.
These three houses right here with the spindles on the porches are the first three we did in this neighborhood.
Reverend John Edgar says the initiative has also helped increase the home values in this community.
Jerry, one of the most impressive things about the whole project is that it is a mixture of public and private dollars working together. None of this would happen without Nationwide Children's Hospital. They're the center energy for the whole venture. And they're putting significant amounts of money into both pay for staff time to coordinate the project and also for subsidy dollars.
As Nationwide Children's Hospital grows and provides more health care for more children, it is also uplifting the entire neighborhood around it, the entire area, with new housing, educational opportunities. And so as the boat is lifted for Nationwide Children's Hospital, so are all boats in the entire area of that part of the city, and therefore the whole city has improved as a result.
Laquita and her girls moved into their new home just a few months ago.
It's not just about the hospital. It's about everything around it. And with the hallways, what was nice with the design is that they actually made them wider for wheelchair accessibility. So it's really nice when we go to turn the corners and things like that.
The home is ADA compliant, and by working with Healthy Neighborhoods, Healthy Families, Laquita was able to customize the house with lower light switches, bigger doorways, and a new ramp to help Ziza get to the bus and off to school.
I mean, it's always nice to have a place you can call home. So, and I'm glad I was able to, you know, provide that for them. It's a dream come true for me and, you know, in turn, you know, a dream for them too, so.
And along with revitalizing Columbus's South Side, the project will impact nearly 10,000 residents every year.
Here outside the new hospital, we're standing in the new garden. This 6-acre green space is right outside the new front door of the hospital. The park space adjoins Livingston Park, the oldest park in the city. With mazes and a scented garden, it's a place for kids and families to relax when visiting the hospital.
Well, it's time to go inside the new building.
When we return, we'll show you how the themes and designs of the new hospital bring the outdoors inside.
Let's go. Today this
could be. You're watching Everything Matters inside the new Nationwide Children's Hospital. When we come back.
Part of the messaging is hopeful and free. And again, that image of healing nature is really important to us. Yeah.
Today this could be the greatest day of our lives. Today this could be the greatest day of our lives.
I think anytime you have children, you're gonna, and somebody is hurt, you go to Nationwide Children's. And for us, we have four sons, and our third son, Ike, developed RSV at a month old.
In addition to the RSV, which is an upper respiratory condition, he had strep pneumonia and was starting to go into shock. And within about 2 minutes, we were back in the critical care area of the ER, and we had probably four doctors and a team of additional 6 to 8 nurses and all kinds of other staff, and it just took over. He was in the pediatric ICU for 9 days.
Just to see where he was and where he is today is amazing. And we're just so grateful that he was where he was at the right time. And we had all the people giving him the care that he needed.
We are now at the front information desk at Nationwide Children's Hospital. Many visitors will come here first when they visit the building.
But just around the corner is a special wall in the main hallway. The names on this wall represent the nearly 79,000 donors who made a gift to the Change Their Tomorrow campaign to transform this campus. But it's important to remember the hospital values a $10 donation as much as the larger contributions. It takes an entire community to build and support a new hospital, and each of you are a part of this success. Everything mattered when it came to the design and themes of this new hospital.
The goal was not only to provide visitors with an easy way to get around the building, but to give kids and families a sense of comfort, optimism, and hope.
There are big and exciting changes at the new Nationwide Children's Hospital. A new front door and the addition of underground patient parking.
Part of the original idea in 2006, the 2007, was we built the parking garage across Livingston, and we had this big bridge that came across, and one day we just said, well, stop. You know, you're gonna have families coming with strollers and wagons and sick kids. You know, is that what we really want? And we were fortunate enough to have, you know, saved money on some of the construction that allowed us to put, and with the city's help, allowed us to put the parking underground. So all of our patients who come that way will arrive, you know, underground. They're welcomed from there, and then we'll come up and have the great desk.
Once checking in at the info desk, just to the right is the atrium.
It's pretty cool.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Where birds fly overhead and nature comes indoors.
That was really the hope. And so the theming of the trees, of nature coming inside and being part of this experience with so much light is what we were really hoping for. So exactly as you said, that families walk in and they feel hopeful. You know, it's not an institutional feeling or a depressing place. It's full of light. It's themed with images of flight. So our birds are flying. You'll hear soundscapes that will remind you of being outside. And we've got butterflies, and there's flow through the entire design.
There is also a massive tree with clocks that'll ring at different times of the day.
Thought was put into everything from the ceiling to the floor, and we're walking along the blue line, so to speak. Yeah. What does that mean? What's behind this?
So part of what we found, and frankly part of what we experienced with our own hospital, is it was a maze. I mean, there's no other way to say it. I've come here, you know, thousands of times. Yeah. And it's difficult to find your way around. So if it's difficult for us, imagine a family arriving for the first time. And so how did we incorporate, use design to do wayfinding? So we can say follow the blue line all the way down the corridor until you reach X, and there's a way for families to orient themselves.
Along the way, the nature themes are carried throughout the hallways of the building. Butterflies and animal images at all levels for kids of all different heights.
Can you find a green butterfly?
With large video information monitors throughout the building, parents can see maps and find the information they need as well. The colored wayfinding is also incorporated upstairs on the patient floors.
There's a split, so there's seasonal colors that are that are cued off of each side. And again, families will remember I was on the pink side, not the yellow side. Or using color, using design to make life easier for our families.
On each floor is an animal friend.
So I have to admit, the animal friends are absolutely my favorite.
Yeah.
And again, we were trying to come up with an idea that we could carry through both the new facility and the old that brought nature in and at the same time would delight our kids.
The bunny.
Where's the bunny?
Right there.
There's the frog.
To create the animal friends, the hospital worked with Carousel Works in Mansfield, which is the largest manufacturer of wooden carousels in the world. They chose animals that are natural to Ohio, things kids could find in their own backyard, like a rabbit, a snail, an owl, and a frog. A total of 18 animal friends now live at Nationwide Children's Hospital.
We're on a patient floor and we call this the niche. And again, we really try to be mindful of the kid. Yeah. So what does he experience? What things are too high? The animal friends we brought down to a point where most kids could see them. We just rode the elevator and I know you noticed that there were designs on the ceiling.
Yeah.
So if you've got a kid in a bed, I mean, they're looking up. Yeah. So really trying to get in the mind, that mindset of experiencing the environment through the child's eyes.
There's a fun fact about animals or nature on each niche.
Mice are afraid of heights. Who knew?
Who knew? But they're all true.
Drink water, they absorb it through their skin.
No kid wants to be here, but if there's one moment where they can smile coming through or a sibling can smile, then you know we've done our job.
We are following the blue path now until the walls turn green, a very important area of this hospital.
Nationwide Children's is known as a level one trauma center. When we come back, the new emergency department.
Today this could be the greatest day of our lives.
Everything matters. Inside the new Nationwide Children's Hospital, we'll continue.
The greatest day of our lives.
Our story with Children's Hospital started the day he was born. During my pregnancy, I knew that he would be born with a significant heart defect. And there was a strong possibility that he'd also be born with Down syndrome. Well, he came into the world a little bit differently, and he ended up being transported to Children's several hours after he was born. We have come to rely on the care we get not only at the main hospital, but also at all of the close-to-home facilities as well. It has provided just that peace of mind for caring for him, that we know we have that team in our backyard.
The new emergency department is one of the main focal points of the new hospital.
Everything mattered in the details, from the ease of access for the squads to the efficient pathway from the helipad to the trauma rooms.
The newly designed emergency department is key to help get your child healthy and on the way to recovery as quickly as possible. Dr. Leslie Mahalov takes us on a quick tour.
Right now, we're in our new lobby.
Eight registration queues, not two.
We kind of have a queuing line that goes over there, but we have multiple areas where the patients can check in, which is really nice.
Once you enter the emergency department, the children and their families get a great look at this 1,400-gallon aquarium. The fish help distract and calm kids before they're attended to by the staff.
This is so exciting. One of the things that happens, you know, no one really wants their child to get sick and no one wants to really be here, but if they have to come here, what we want to do as much distraction as we can. So allowing the children to stand at the fish tank, and you know, fish are mesmerizing, and children love the colors and love all the excitement about it. So it's beautiful, and it's great for the staff too.
And we broke it.
Once you're checked in, you go around the other side and be taken back into a room.
When you go back to the exam room, the differences stand out. The hallways are built to accommodate the new patient load.
We have wider hallways because we wanted to be able to fit more people going each way, as well as because the rooms are so much bigger, the hallways are longer. And we knew that we were going to have longer hallways, so one of the things that we did was made sure that we had little kiosks, basically, for the nurses to be able to get supplies and also to do their documentation. This is the ambulance entrance, and it's very quick entry into the what we call our trauma critical care area.
This is 2-year-old call patient, male, Hal. He was found injected from a high-speed NVC at the scene.
On this day, the doctors and nurses of the emergency department were practicing to get used to the new surroundings.
No breath sounds on the right.
Kathy Haley, the trauma program manager, picks up our tour from here.
You're currently standing in the trauma rooms, and there's many things that are new. And in part, we did it because everything matters. The things that we have a big screen monitor that we're able to see the child's heart rate and a big monitor versus a little monitor. If you would notice, this room is pretty warm, and warm matters with an injured child. So this room can be cranked up to 80 degrees and the child can be made warm.
Can we get a CBC?
What really matters in this room is having a very dynamic, skilled team of trauma team responders. We do that very well. We've got a long history of being a level one pediatric trauma center. And what we did is took those skills that we do and the kinds of equipment that we need and the environment that we need to make the child's outcome the best that we can.
With the anticipation of 1 million patient visits to Nationwide Children's for 2012, the emergency department is up to the task for caring for the sickest of the sick. The new design can support up to 8 EMS vehicles at one time. The new helipad can hold a Black Hawk helicopter. And why does that matter?
Not only are we managing the day-to-day trauma activity, but we need to prepare for major disaster events. In our world, it's our obligation to make sure that we can provide the best commitment to our community in disaster preparedness. So we have disaster resources that are very much enhanced in comparison to what we've had before.
And because attention to detail is so important in this high-pressure environment, the team practices over and over to make sure every second counts, a second that could save your child's life.
Care for kids, and in this room we save lives, and seconds make a difference, and frankly everything matters in those life-saving seconds.
When a child comes to the hospital and has to stay the night, it is nice to know Nationwide Children's has done everything possible to make patient rooms comfortable.
For the kids and the parents, inside the newly designed patient rooms when we come back.
For me, I think as a mother, I was looking at the aesthetics of the room. It's a pretty room, nice and bright.
Today, this could be the greatest day of our lives. Before it all ends, before we run out of time. Stay close to me. Watch the world come alive tonight.
Welcome back to Everything Matters, inside the new Nationwide Children's Hospital.
So that was such an important thing for us because I think there's been an evolution in thought about that family experience. And, you know, years ago, hospitals would be designed to accommodate the work of the nurses and doctors. And of course, that's of paramount importance, but the family's experience is so important. Yeah. So recognizing that the family is gonna be there. If your child is sick and in the hospital for days on end, weeks on end, the families are gonna be living in the hospital. So making them comfortable, you know, recognizing we need a comfortable place for them to sleep, to shower, to hang their clothes, to be a part of their child's life in that time of turmoil and tension. So again, accepting it and embracing it.
When you are a parent of a patient here at Nationwide Children's, everything matters. But number one is the comfort and care of your kid.
And that's where the years of research and development by Nationwide Children's staff comes into play. They thought of everything, so you don't have to.
Moving into a new hospital is exciting. Taking on this huge move is very difficult. Everything matters, and that's why Nationwide Children's called upon the experts to help design the new patient rooms. Nurses, family advisor groups, and good old-fashioned visits to other hospitals for ideas helped put everyone's mind at ease when the final product started to take shape.
It really just means the world that not only was it important to the leadership at Children's to have a great facility, but it was important to meet the needs of the family. They get family-centered care. They understand how important that is for the overall healing of the patient.
So we created a family advisory group just for this reason. They're the ones, you know, who are here day after day. So the insight that they gave us in terms of what they needed in the family rooms, in the patient rooms, for example, or just small things was of the greatest importance to us.
But to get to this point, there were years of hard work behind the design.
Spray painted the rooms on the floor, and then we actually brought a bed over, and we brought patients over in wheelchairs and put some rocking chairs and some other furnishings in, and tried and moved them around the room to see where we got the most space.
One of the things that was important for us to do is we put up full-scale mock-ups of many parts of this building over in a warehouse, and we had a series of parent visits come through and say, tell us what this is like for you and what needs to be different. And based on these parents' input in their children, we made a number of changes, things that we would never have thought of because we don't see it from the parents' point of view, and have done that in a way to try to make the experience better for them.
The hospital staff reviewed the design and gave input. The turnout was huge.
The staff came over and I think they were like, oh my gosh, they listened to us.
Everything has been redone, rethought, and replaced.
From a staff side, the area right by the door is considered the nursing zone. And so we have created this nurse server cart, and these were custom made specifically for us.
Everything the nurses need is in the nurse's cart, computer, keyboard, drawers to keep supplies in. Everything has a place. Every nurse's cart is exactly the same in every room to keep things streamlined and safe for the nurses. Keeping the room standardized keeps the nurses efficient. A new addition is a lockbox for valuables for the families. Also a closet with hooks, not hangers, for the family baggage has been added. The addition of the foot wall storage gives the families even more room. Space is so important because some of the families essentially move in. So the nurses and the family groups got together to make sure there will be a place for the families to put their things. But the biggest addition for the moms and dads is the pull-out sofa. It wasn't enough to choose a comfortable couch. The team designers insisted on sleeping on one before they approved it. In fact, all the patient rooms were designed with the entire family in mind. So now, when parents want to spend the night with their child, they'll get a good night's sleep right in their child's room.
And I swore when we got this bed that I would sleep on it or lay on it or spend a lot of time on it to make sure that it was very comfortable before we picked the final sofa. This bottom piece actually comes out, and you'll have a second sleeping surface for second person in the room as well.
The lighting panel for the room has three functions, a room light, exam light, and a reading light. But there's also one special light for the room.
We have this illuminated head wall above the gases. This is actually can be patient controlled. You can have it rolling through the different colors, or there's actually a switch on the wall that you can actually stop it on specific colors.
The bathroom area is custom made. The bathtub has a lower lip so kids can get in and out safely. There's a seat that folds down. The hose is adjustable. There are a couple of shelves that were requested by the nurses to help keep the bathroom neat and tidy. The bathroom also has a slip-resistant floor. Reaction from the patients and families has been overwhelming.
They sent us up to his hospital room, which is in the new building, while he was finishing up in the after post-operative area. We came up to the room and I was absolutely overcome. I mean, I really had kind of a very full circle moment where we walked into the room and it was exactly what we had visioned and worked for the last 6 or 7 years. I mean, it's everything we wanted. It was almost like walking into a hotel room. It was fabulous.
Felicity Sneesby has been a patient at Nationwide Children's for almost 10 years. She found her favorite addition to the new rooms.
A bigger telly?
The large screen TV serves many purposes. It has the Get Well Network, used to introduce you to the hospital. The screen is also used for patient education, and the families can watch movies or play video games.
For me, I think as a mother, I was looking at the aesthetics of the room. It's a pretty room, nice and bright.
Magnetic paint has been used on one of the walls so the kids can hang up their Get Well cards or information.
Every little detail is important, and it makes a difference in how the final product comes out and is completed.
Our tour of the new hospital continues in the newly designed rehabilitation and clinical therapy space.
I love what's next, how crews got a full-scale car in the building here on the 9th floor when we return.
The area we're in right now is Determination Way. And Determination Way was a name that we came upon because we really wanted to talk about a child's journey and their determination to get back to a higher level of functioning.
Every one of my children has used the facilities of Children's. They all have. Daniel's used it a lot more than the rest of them, clearly. And I'm telling you, it's a safe place to go. When in doubt, this is where we want our kids to come when something is wrong. We just don't know what a gem we have in this community in the way of Children's Hospital.
Once your child is on the road to recovery, rehab is next. And because everything matters, Nationwide Children's has done everything possible to make sure your child's needs are met.
That's right. In the newly designed rehabilitation and clinical therapy space, your child will get the therapy and the confidence they need to excel once again after an injury.
Kaylee Hurley's relationship with Nationwide Children's Hospital started 2 years ago.
I had a spinal cord stroke and the blood stopped flowing through my spine for a little too long. It really changed my life in the course of 2 hours.
Today, she's visiting the new inpatient rehabilitation area for the first time.
So cool.
Located on the 9th floor, the center has everything to help patients like Kaylee during their stay. All of the tools, equipment, and simulated areas are located in one place.
It's so nice to have everything in one spot so you don't have to go all around the hospital to learn how to do something. Like the cafeteria, I had to go to the cafeteria to learn. Now they have it right in the gym, and it's great to have it right there so you don't have to go all over the hospital to learn it.
Before, we had a gym that was shared for inpatient and outpatient, and we had other little satellite gyms that were spread kind of across the hospital. This allows us to bring all the children that are inpatients into one spot. It makes it easier for the therapist, it makes it easier for the child, and there's a lot of different equipment. We were really doing many things up in the patient rooms, and this gives us some very innovative, state-of-the-art equipment to rehabilitate and get the strength and endurance of the kids back faster.
And what was Kaylee's favorite part of the tour?
I love the car.
Honda donated a 4-door Honda Civic sedan to the rehabilitation unit at Nationwide Children's Hospital.
We love to get in this.
The Honda Civic was lifted by crane onto the 9th floor of the new main hospital. Honda's Research and Development Center in Ohio modified the car to be used for rehabilitation patients to practice getting in and out of a vehicle.
I had to learn outside when it was cold and snowy, and it was kind of hard to learn outside when you're distracted by how cold it is. But where it's inside, it's going to be a whole lot easier for patients to learn. And it's going to be way more convenient than having to go outside again into the snow. And it's really cool.
We're going to go ahead and move the car up. And as you can see, this would be at about the level of some of our sports utility vehicles. And we would be able to really imitate that motion for a child being able to get in and out with their family here and being able to practice.
The area is known as Determination Way. Helping children rehabilitate and get back to a higher level of functioning is what matters.
It was really intense, but I knew I could do it because they told me I could, and I did.
The new Nationwide Children's expansion includes a brand new research center as well.
Coming up, why that building across Parsons is so important for the future of pediatric health care.
You are watching Everything Matters inside the new Nationwide Children's Hospital.
Its expansion is going to have a dramatic impact on the city of Columbus. First of all, to make it one of the top children's hospitals in the entire nation. And that's very important for research and taking care of lives of our young people, taking care of the health of our young people.
Because everything matters, Nationwide Children's research and development teams are working hard to secure your child's healthy future.
With the goal of finding answers to your questions and new treatments for this community and beyond, the new research building behind us is yet another jewel in the crown of Nationwide Children's Hospital.
Research Building 3 is slated to open in late summer as a $93 million six-floor, world-class research facility. The new building is a great asset to the Wexner Institute for Pediatric Research. Dr. Lynette Rogers will be using space in the building. She explains the open concept.
It almost doubles the amount of research space we have. It also uses an incredibly new and innovative open concept that allows us to work in collaboration with people that are doing analysis and have research interests that are similar to our own. And this will allow us to hopefully come up with some new advances and new ideas more quickly, and that we'll be more ready to bring those to the bedside.
The building also has some informal spaces for researchers to gather.
This area is one of the collaborative areas built in this building. As you can see, it allows for casual conversation and interaction between different principal investigators and their staff and the staffs of multiple people. And this is the type of environment that hatches brand new ideas.
With this new building comes increased funding. Over the past 10 years, funding for research at Nationwide Children's has tripled. The funding not only helps Nationwide Children's, but it helps you and our community.
We have been very successful at growing research at the hospital over the last several years, and we've just run out of research space in the two research buildings we have now. So this 225,000 square foot third research building is important for us to continue to grow the enterprise and bring world-class scientists in.
It offers the best in healthcare for the children of the community with the ability to practice cutting-edge medicine and to offer the community the best of the physicians and the researchers. It's the best of all worlds for their children.
Because everything matters, Nationwide Children's is one of the only hospitals in the country that is freestanding, that has its own research institute. The hospital is also one of the top 10 research centers based on funding in the country. Because of this, the children who need the help the most will benefit from the research that will happen right across the street.
I think that it offers a very essential component to making the building across the street one of the nation's best children's hospitals in the world. And I'd like to see this just continue to expand, potentially with additional research buildings and more investigators and more money being focused on both preventing and curing some of the diseases of children.
We are coming to the end of our tour of the new Nationwide Children's Hospital, but wait till you see what we have coming up next.
Take a walk and play in a magic forest when we come back.
Everything Matters, inside the new Nationwide Children's Hospital. We'll continue. Welcome back to Everything Matters, inside the new Nationwide Children's Hospital.
Now, the last place we want to show you is a very special place inside the new Nationwide Children's Hospital. It's filled with larger-than-life animal friends and trees and the sounds of a real forest.
You know, Jerry, what was once a corridor between two buildings has become a magic forest, a place where parents and guests can rest and relax, get away from the stress of being in a hospital, and a place where the wild ones can play.
Hey, I heard you were a wild one. Ooh, if I took you home and be a woman, show me how you do. I wanna shut down the cloud with you. Hey, I heard you like the wild ones, wild ones, wild ones. Oh,
There's a frog back there.
Doctor, talk about a kid. Friendly space. This is your magic forest?
That's right.
It's so pretty. I wish I could do my room like this. Oh, I gotta run.
The amazing thing about the magic forest, I don't know if someone told you, was that it was actually found space because we had two buildings that were intersecting and a corridor that we wanted to create, and we had this empty space, and we said, wait a minute, you know, if we cover the top and put a skylight on and capture this space, it happens to be across from the cafe, what would we create that would be a wonderful place for families to have a moment?
I want to go underneath the tree. Going wild, fist pumping music. I might lose it. Glass to the roof, how we lose it, lose it, lose it. I don't care tonight, she don't care. We like almost there. I'm more excited than the Logan. Take me surprise, jumping those dives, surfing the crowd. Then I gotta be the man, I'm the head of my band. Might check 1, 2. Just to say I went through a tree.
That is nice. Gotta break boost, cause that's the motto.
So we came up with this idea of the magic forest, again, incorporating our animals and then these monolithic trees. And the idea is, again, nature's coming inside, but there are lots of surprises for the kids. Yeah. So there's a tree they can walk through, and there are tasks for them to do in terms
crawl
of
through
crawl
areas.
Through, yeah. Finding places, mm-hmm. And you know, hopefully families will come and have a cup of coffee and take a moment, and there'll be stuff for the kids to do. Yeah. And again, delight it to the extent that we can in this kind of setting.
Oh, look at that. Can you get through there?
Look at them climbing through it.
But also within this space, there's a 3D soundscape. There'll also be animation on the walls that continues the graphic elements that you see. There'll also be things that will hand out little cards and will say, can you find the butterfly that's on a leaf, or can you go find the squirrel?
You could play I Spy with this.
A robot?
Find me!
Look at the flamingo, mama.
It's pretty cool.
Amazing.
Yeah. We'll also have tables so that parents who've gotten coffee or ice cream or whatever can come and have just some respite time.
I want to go through the tunnel so bad.
It makes me feel like a little kid.
All right, that is great. A whole hour in here.
Thank you for joining us for Everything Matters inside the new Nationwide Children's Hospital.
You are invited to come check out the new hospital on Community Celebration Day this Sunday, June 10th from 11 to 4. Then the building officially opens June 20th, 2012.
Now, we hope it's a place you don't have to visit, but if you do, know that everything matters when it comes to the health and happiness of your child. Good night.
Tonight, this could be the greatest night of our lives. Let's
fake a new start. The future is ours to find. Can you see?